Now let's talk about asystole, sometimes referred to as flatline on the monitor. It represents the absence of both electrical and mechanical activity of the heart. Now, if the patient doesn't have a pulse and asystole is confirmed in one lead, we should check another lead and the monitor's amplitude to make sure it's not fine V-fib. Like in PEA, it's also important to determine the H's and T's to discover why the patient went into cardiac arrest and to treat any reversible causes of asystole. Remember, asystole is not a shockable rhythm, and treatment for asystole involves high-quality CPR, airway management, IV or IO therapy, and medication therapy, which is 1 milligram epinephrine 1 to 10,000 every 3 to 5 minutes rapid IV or IO push. It's rare for asystole to be reversed, especially after a long duration. Although it is a difficult choice to stop resuscitation efforts, if the patient does not respond to the BLS and ACLS treatments, the decision to terminate resuscitation efforts needs to be made. And if you have a high degree of certainty that the patient will not respond to further ACLS interventions, it would be appropriate to stop. The decision must be based on your specific protocols and the consideration of time from collapse to CPR, time from collapse to first defibrillation attempt, underlying causes, response to resuscitative measures, and especially the ETCO2 less than 10 after 20 minutes of CPR. All will contribute to your decision to stop resuscitative efforts in the asystole patient.